In this equation, we have calcium chloride, and we're adding it to sodium phosphate in a double displacement reaction. Let's count the atoms up. We have one calcium atom, two chlorines, three sodiums, and then because I have this PO4 here, this phosphate, and I have it over here, I can just say I have one phosphate. That'll make things a lot easier. Three calciums, and then this two applies to everything, so I have two phosphates here. So put a two here for my phosphates, then one sodium and one chlorine. So it looks like we could try to just balance the calciums first. Why don't we put a coefficient of three? So we have the one calcium times the three. That'll give us three calcium. Those are balanced. And then two times three, we have six chlorine atoms. Okay, why don't we try to fix the chlorines by putting a six in front of the NaCl? So we have one times six for the sodium. That equals six. Chlorine's one times six. So now the chlorines are balanced. So it looks like we're kind of down to the sodiums. If we put a two in front of the sodium phosphate, this Na3PO4, we'd have three times two, and that would equal six, so that would be balanced. And then our phosphate, this two applies to the whole thing here, so we have two of these phosphates, two times the one phosphate. That'll give us two phosphates, and we're done. This equation is balanced. So by counting this phosphate as just one item, that made the balancing a lot easier. This is Dr. B with the balanced equation for CaCl2 plus Na3PO4, and thanks for watching.